Good evening, students. Now the topic for today is recursion or recursive functions in C programming language. In our previous lecture, we have seen the parameter passing to the functions. Now, what do you mean by recursion or recursive function? A function which calls itself again and again during the program execution is called a recursion or recursive function. Take the example of a factorial of a number. If I want to find the factorial of 3, say, I can write, to calculate the factor of 3, I can write 3 into 2 factorial. It means that I must know factorial of 2 to find the factorial of 3. Then to get the factorial of 2, I can write it as 2 into 1 factorial. It means to get the factorial of 2, I must know what is the factorial of 1. And as we know, the factor of 1 is only 1. So the final calculation for this factorial calculation will be 3 into 2 into 1. And that goes to 6. So, 3 factorial is nothing but 6. It means that during the calculation of the factorial of a number, a function is calling to itself. And such type of calling the function to itself is called as recursive function. To understand this very well, we will see one program of finding a factorial of a number using a recursion. We will start with the header files. Hash include studio.h, hash include conio.h, then in the main program here, we'll open the program here, we'll declare the function to calculate the factorial of a number, which takes only one parameter, that is the number whose factorial is needed. So, int fact int semicolon. This is just a declaration or the function prototype. It is defined after the main program. Then we need a number from the user whose factorial is needed. So we declare variable n for that, which hold the number whose factorial is required. Clear screen will clear the screen. This printf will prompt a message to the user to enter the number whose factorial is required. The another scanf statement is responsible for reading the number whose factorial is required. So, ampersand n will going to store that number. The next printf line will print the factorial of that number. Factorial of percentage d is percentage d. That is the number, and then we call that factorial function and the result will be printed in this line. Whenever we call this function here, the compiler will jump from this line to the function definition where it copy the value of n into x. Now see the definition of fact function, how it is written. Consider the user entered the value 3 in variable n. Then 3 gets copied into x. For further calculation, we declare another variable f. That is redundant variable in this program. Then before proceeding, we will check if the entered value by the user is 1. If this is true, we directly return the factor of that particular number is 1. The factor of number 1 is 1. Else, we will write a formula f equal to x into fact of x minus 1, semicolon. Now, how we have written this line? The way we have seen before in theory, to find the factorial of 3, we write 3 into 2 factorial. It means f equal to x into, this is fact of x minus 1. Here in the case of this problem is, we have considered x as 3. 3 minus 1 is so, we write 3 factorial as 3 into 2 factorial. So, by that, we can write a line in the program that f equal to x into fact of x minus 1 in the else part. So, whenever we pass value 3, this line becomes 3 into fact of 2. It means that to get the factorial of 3, there is another call internally goes to find the factorial of 2, and the cursor goes here and the now value of x becomes 2. For further calculation, again it goes to the else part and this line becomes 3 into 2 into fact of 1. Again it goes back, now the value of x is 1. Here it checks the condition and the condition becomes 2 and this will return 1 to the same line where that fax function was called, that is nothing but this line, and the calculation becomes 3 into 2 into 1 and final result is 6, that gets stored into variable f and this line will return variable f to the calling function and here it will print that value 6 and this printf line will going to print a message on the screen that factorial of 3 is 6. So this ends a recursive program on finding the factorial of a number using recursion. Any doubt, students? You can write your doubts into the chat room. Any questions on recursive function or recursion? A function which calls itself again and again is called a recursive function. To understand that concept, we have seen a program to find the factorial of a number using a recursion. Now we'll see another program to find the sum of n natural numbers using recursion. Write a program to find the sum of n numbers using recursion. We'll start with the header file. Hash include stdio.h and hash include conio.h, void main, opening bracket, we declare the function here, int sum int, and then the main program where we take a number from the user to find the limit, how many numbers to be added. So clear screen will clear the screen, printf will print the message on the screen, enter the numbers, number of terms in the calculation of sum of n numbers. So that will be stored into a variable n here. Okay. In the next line, we'll call that function sum equal to percentage d, comma sum of n. So from here it goes to the definition of sum function. Consider I entered the value 3 in variable n. It means the value of x becomes 3. N value gets copied into x. So value of x becomes 3. This function will take another variable f as a resultant variable, which gives the result of 3 numbers. If x equal to 1, directly we will return 1. Else, we will write a formula f equal to x plus sum of x minus 1. So this line will calculate or perform the addition of that number plus the previous number. So this sum of x minus 1 is nothing but the sum function is calling to itself again with the value reduced by 1. So we assume that the x value was 3. So this line becomes 3 plus sum of 2. So x value is 2 now here, and again in the next iteration it goes to the else part and that line becomes 3 plus 2 plus sum of 1. Again it goes back to check the condition and the condition is true here and it returns 1 to the same line here and the calculation becomes 3 plus 2 plus 1 and the final result is 3 plus 2 plus 1, the final result is 6. It gets stored into f and that it will return that result to the same line where that function gets called into the main program. So this will print the sum of n numbers using a recursion. So this ends the second program on a recursion function. There may be any program asked on the concept of recursion, like power of a number using recursion, factorial of a number using recursion, sum of n natural numbers using recursion, and so on. We can write any program that we have written using any loop can be written using recursion. Okay. So this ends your second program. If you have any doubt, you can ask me now. Okay, there are no doubts. Thank you for watching the video.